Hello my dear students, welcome back to my English literature class. I am Anjana Jindal and today I am back here with chapter number 11 of our Mulberry book, that is Making a Difference. So children, in my previous video of part 1 of this chapter, I had explained you the story, and now in today's class I am going to discuss the word meanings and few exercises based on making connections and word wall with you. Okay. So children, now here are the word meanings which I have already explained you during the explanation of the chapter also. Okay, so let's have a recall. Okay, so first one, dejectedly, which means in an unhappy and disappointed manner. Okay. Second one, unusual, which means something that does not happen often or is not often seen. Means something different from the things usually you do. Okay, that is unusual. Right. Now shikarni. Shikarni is a spiced sweet dessert. Okay, it's a sweet dish. Yes. Momos, a food made of flour with filling of vegetables or meat. Next is amma, that is mother in Nepalese. Bua, father in Nepalese. Next word is concerned, which means worried. Next is helpless, which means not able to do things without help. Next is starfish. Starfish is a flat sea creature in the shape of a star with five arms. Okay. Next word is tight. It is regular rise and fall in the level of the sea caused by the pull of the moon or the sun. Next word is trudged, which means walked slowly with heavy steps. Next is out of breath, which means having difficulty breathing because of exercise. If you are doing some exercises, no, so you feel difficult to breathe, that is out of breath. Okay. And last is rapt, which means deep interest. Okay. So children, all these word meanings you have to write down in your Mulberry copy. Okay. So children, here is our exercise of making connections. The first question is based on quick answers. So make the correct sequence of the events of Mitty and Mahendra's day. So children, here some events from the story are given, which you have to arrange in the order as they happened in the story. Okay. So children, what happened first? Yes, Mitty and Mahendra attend a science club meeting at school. Yes, so we'll put number one here. What happened next? Mitty and Mahendra walked home together. Yes. So here is our second one. Then what happened next? Mitty and Mahendra are not excited about food. Yes. So A part is the third one. Then what happened? The parents ask Mitty and Mahendra if they have been quarreling. Yes. Because they were upset, no? Yeah, they were sad and they both were quiet. That's why parents asked. Yes. So then what happened next? The children tell their parents why they are dejected. Yes. So number D is number 5. And at the end, their mother tells them a story. Yes, their mother tells them the story. And after listening to the story, they were able to think differently. Isn't it? Yes. So now children, question number 2. Put a tick against the sentences that are true and a cross against those that are false. So these are true and false. So let's read the sentences one by one. So A part, Mitty and Mahendra usually quarreled on the way home back school. Do they quarrel? Is it true? No, it is false. They usually used to discuss about what happened in the school. All their lessons they used to tell each other, no? What they learnt in the school that particular day, no? Yeah. So this one is false. So you have to put a cross. Okay. Now B part. The beach was covered with dying jellyfish. So children, was the beach covered with dying jellyfish or with dying starfish? Yes, starfish. So this one is also not true. So you have to put a cross. Now C part. Mitty and Mahendra cared about the environment. Yes, that's true. They cared about the environment. That's why only they were worried, no? That lot of wrong has been done to the environment, and now they were not thinking, means they were not able to think that what could they do to save that, isn't it? Yes, so this is true. So we have to put a tick mark. Okay. Now the last one. Mahendra was fond of ice candy. Yes, of course he was fond of ice candy. That's why it was written, no? That usually he stopped the candy man and used to buy, no, if he had money. Yeah, but that day he did not run to the candy man. So this one is also true and we'll put a tick. Okay. So now children, next exercise is word wall. So this question is based on prefix. You know what is a prefix? Yes, children, a prefix is a group of letters we put before a word. And when we put prefix, then the word take the opposite meaning. This also known as negation. Okay. See, as you have read in the story, na, the word unusual. Yes. So the word is usual, and when we put a prefix un before that word, means un when we add, then it becomes unusual and the meaning becomes the opposite one. Okay. So here is the exercise. Question number one. Choose one of the prefixes il, im, or un to add to these words so that they take the opposite meanings. This is also known as negation. Okay, so children, here the first word is kind. What will we add to the word kind? Which prefix we will use out of these? Yes, un, that is unkind. Yes, and this word is opposite in the meaning to kind. Okay, so next word is legal. So which prefix we will add? Yes, il. So it will become illegal. Now the next word is happy. Now we'll make it as unhappy. Now the next word is natural. Now we will add un as prefix to make its opposite, isn't it? So unnatural. Now the next word is possible. Now we will add im and it will become impossible. And now the last word is literate. Yes, it will be made by adding the prefix il and it will become illiterate. Yes. Okay. So children, next exercise, next question is based on environment words. Okay, so find these environment words in the letter grid and circle them. So children, here is a grid. Okay, and you'll definitely enjoy this exercise. Okay, this question. See, the words are given and you have to find out these words in the grid. So as first one is already given, already done. Like the first word is recycle and it is already circled, isn't it? Yes. So rest of the words you have to find out from the grid and you have to circle them out. Okay. So next word is reuse. So children, just find out where is it. Yes. Find out. It is in the second row. Yes. See, this way we will circle it out. Okay. Now the next word is pollute. Where is it? Just search, just find out in the grid. Yes, it is in the last row. Yes, pollute. See, in this way, we will circle it out. Then the next word is conserve. Where is it? Yes, just see. It is there in the fourth row. Yes, conserve. Circle out. Yes, now the next word, extinction. Where is it? Yes, it is in second last row. Extinction. Yes, circle it out. Yes. Now, preserve. Where is preserve? Okay, just search. Okay, it is in the third row. Yes. See, here is preserve. Now, the last word and only one row left. Yes. Which is the fifth row. Yes, it is deforestation. Yes, here it is. So now children, it's the time for your home assignment. So in your homework, you have to read the story again. You have to learn and write the word meanings in your mulberry copy very neatly. And do all the exercises in your book. Okay? With this, bye-bye. Take care.